where that we're not going to lose. And so it's about taking back control and ownership of our own education. And I think what we need to do is to promote it. This is coming from the words of people. We need to promote education as a process of transformation, a process of engagement, a process of partnership. And if we're working in non-Indigenous universities and education systems, what we have to do is, when they talk about engagement and partnerships, that can no longer be superficial. It has to be tangible, it has to be rich in terms of a real partnership, and only we can make that happen. I don't think it's fair that we no longer become subservient to the system, but we have to be able to work on an equal level within the system. And that's about making sure that the scholarship, the rich scholarship of our elders, the rich scholarship of our people within the communities who are educators in their own right, the rich scholarship of our traditional knowledge holders works side by side with those people that we've invested in, because education is an investment, that we've invested in and who've got qualifications within the education system, that we make sure that one does not usurp the other, that they work in tandem together, and never ever undermining the scholarship of the elders, but promoting and building upon the scholarship of the elders. And that's about making sure that we retain our language, we protect our culture, we protect our cultural heritage, our songs, our storylines, our histories, our landmarks. I went into a session this afternoon and they're talking about research and landmarks, and that we all take responsibility. It's a given responsibility, but sometimes we take it for granted. And it's a responsibility that we all need to share, both at the family level, the tribal level, the national level, and the international level. And that's what WINHEC is trying to do. It's trying to bring together people of like mind to leverage some growing desire and burning desire within our lives to make a difference, to make a change. And every year, there's more and more people coming forward and showing evidence that they're doing amazing things back in their home countries. They're doing amazing things. And so sometimes, when we come to these meetings and you're sitting there and you think, oh my gosh, I feel so inept, I don't feel like we're doing enough at home. Everybody's efforts make a contribution. How small it is does not matter, as long as we make a contribution. And so, this is what WINHEC is saying, that it does take courage, it does take tenacity, it takes energy, but it's an investment that's worthwhile. And WINHEC has, hopefully, put in place, I'm just so thrilled that the last point you put up is that we need to start investing in our own higher education systems. A number of years ago back in Australia, having elders involved in higher education was almost unheard of. They would invite them in for a moment, ceremonial occasion, and that would be it. But over the last number of years, elders now take their formal place as scholars within the education system, higher education system. They're elders in residence. Some are supervisors for researchers. Some are examiners. There's been a number of elders who are examiners. There are now councils of elders being established in 7 universities across Australia, and those council of elders sit with the university council. So can change happen? Of course it can. But we have to be the orchestrators, the drivers of that change. So that's it.